taunting me.
Okay, so why go somewhere else if I know there's a giant snook right there and there's plenty of bait? But I am gonna have to get a cast net. Man, that is cool. All right, so I was gonna go to the inlet because that guy was saying he caught a bunch of snook on mullet, but I think I got everything here. There's greenies, there's mullet, there's big snook. And I know at night it's going off. I mean, it was going off over here. So I just gotta go get a couple more things, grab a bite to eat, and I think I'm staying here for the night. Okay, so I got all the gear. Now it's kind of a race against time before the sun sets. I've gotta go out there and try to cast net for those little mullet and those greenies. And then hopefully it won't take too long. And then, I mean, the sun sets in about an hour, so I gotta get them. I'm sure I can get some later tonight around the dock lights. There were plenty last night, but I don't wanna scare the fish that I'm trying to catch as well. So I gotta run do that. And then I gotta run and go get some shrimp as well, just so I have both baits.
Look at this, guys. Little baby pompano. Isn't that cool? Come back in. There's a mullet. That was nuts. I got so much bait, it's ridiculous. I gotta start fishing or that bait's gonna start to die.
Well, that was successful. I got a ton of bait. I got a bunch of greenies and a bunch, as many mullet that I could fit in that little tiny bucket. Oh man, I still gotta get shrimp. All right, I'm incredibly embarrassed. Chalk it up to being tired and I have no words. So I'm re-rigging one of my poles. I have this other one, had a big mullet out. I set it down, it starts to, I see it just sort of jiggling. I just thought the mullet was being chased. I was waiting for the bzzz, you know, to take off. Never did, it just kept sort of rattling. And I'm like, what the hell? I start to walk over and then it just goes boop, and then nothing. And I'm like, what the? I did not set the bail. So I got spooled just now by probably a big snook, maybe a big jack, maybe a tarpon. Like 200, 150 yards maybe. That hurts. You know, that is like so much worse than like losing a fish, a big fish that you see or you know it's a big fish and you lost. That's so much worse because that was just plain stupid. And it was a good fish because it was a nice size mullet. I still can't believe it. What an idiot. Never happened in my life. Hopefully it doesn't happen again. And hopefully I redeem myself. Lots of action, but it is a little early yet. It's high tide, so it's like completely slack, so there's not much going on. So it's probably another hour or two before the current starts to pick up and the fish start feeding again. So it's gonna be a late night, I think. They just came out to play. Oh, there's one. You see that? Anyway, there's like three or four or five snook or trout right around the light now. Yeah. Beauty. Dog. You mind taking a picture for me?
Sure. About 20 inches.
Yeah.
Not bad.
All right, so today was kind of a mixed bag. It's the end of the day, actually the full day one of fishing. And some cool stuff and also some not very cool stuff. started off on that beach. Actually, I got up late because so I couldn't fish the bridge early pre-dawn for snook. Because I was just tired. I only got a few hours of sleep for 2 nights now. I went to the beach instead, and the red tide is still wreaking havoc on my respiratory system, which is crazy to me. The beach sucked, red tide plus all the seaweed. So I went over to my other spot, this park on the Indian River, and it's always been good. Today I just I mean, I caught a few jacks, which was cool, especially on the mirrodeen. But what was just amazing was hooking those tarpon. When I saw that first one and he ate a shrimp, like a tiny little shrimp, and it was like a 4 foot long tarpon, I mean, that was pretty nuts. And then to get a few more hookups on the mirrodeen was amazing. And then the one that I got, and as soon as he hooked up, he snapped the line, which is nuts, or he cut it or something. I got a couple more hits, a couple more follows by tarpon. And then that was it. That spot, I spent a lot of time there because of the tarpon. It was really cool. Tarpon on artificial is awesome. But I just could not land any, get any for pictures. And there just wasn't anything else going on. Even those giant sheep head were not really playing nice. So I stayed there for a long time because there really aren't other options. Went to the bridge in the afternoon, and that was dead. I mean, I got a bunch of mangroves, and that was it. No snook whatsoever. And then it was promising the evening bite over at this dock here because I saw the big snook that are always there. They're like 35, 40 inches easy, and they're always there. There's like two or three of them. And I managed to get all that bait, and one of the most embarrassing things ever to happen to me fishing. It is the worst. It's worse than falling in the water. It's worse than losing a big fish, or maybe not a fish of a lifetime. I think that's the worst. But to get spooled, I had a big mullet. I tossed it out. It was beautiful. The sun was setting. I had like two different cameras set up. It was gonna make some amazing footage. There were blow-ups on the water, and I had the mullet in, and I was messing around with another rod, and I saw it like just dancing. So I just thought it was the mullet. No, this guy here, he forgot to set the bail. So that little tap, 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 tap was a fish that had grabbed my mullet and was taken off with it. And I'm like watching it tap, 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 tap. And then I start to finally get curious after like a minute of that. And I start to walk over, and then it just goes pop. And that was the end of the line snapping off the reel. I can't believe that. And it's just gonna bother me forever wanting to know what that was. I assume it was probably a big jack because it just sort of went out with it. But like deep down, I'm praying it was a ladyfish. That's it. No giant jacks, no snook. I doubt it was a snook. No tarpon. I'm just hoping it was a big ladyfish. So yeah, that was just embarrassing and awful. And then I fished the rest of the evening at the dock here with all those bait, and I mean, I kept getting ladyfish on the mullet, but that was it. I could not get anything else to bite. And then finally, I caught a nice sized trout on a shrimp, about the same size I caught last night, except this time I got a picture finally because I got the Boca grips. So yeah, that was it. And then it just kind of died, and there's no wind out there, so it's really calm as you see. And just, I mean, the trout were playing with the shrimp. They were playing with the greenies. I had live greenies. The trout would come up and just nuzzle it, and go away. So I could see the trout in the water, but they just stopped biting. There's not a lot of current because it was like outgoing tide. And on the way in, I found these giant snook. They're hanging around in shallower water, two giants. And when I threw a shrimp near them, it spooked them. If I threw a greenie near them, they just disappeared. Not interested in greenies or shrimp. I didn't get a chance to try a mullet because I didn't have any left, but I don't know. Short of maybe catching a big ladyfish, I don't know how to hook these big old snook over here, these specific ones. Okay, so tomorrow morning, and try the pre-dawn patrol again. Snook at the bridge, and then maybe come back here, try to catch some mullet, and then head over to my spot on the Indian River and try to hook up with the tarpon. So if I get some bait, hopefully maybe throw that for some snook. Otherwise, I am going for tarpon in the morning, and it's kind of a short day because I'm going to head up to Gainesville, spend the night there, and then I'm headed over to Cedar Key Thursday morning early. So that's it, man. I know this is a long outro for this one day, but a lot happened, and it was pretty crazy. So that's it. I think that's all. I'll see you in the morning. Look at that. Tailing red, tailing black drum. Right next to my shrimp. There he is. Big red, big red.